Hey guys, welcome to the channel. In this video tutorial, we'll be modifying the default form of Shopify store. We'll be adding a few more fields like dropdown, radio buttons, and text fields to the existing Shopify form. You can create this contact form from the Shopify admin by creating a new page and assigning a template. There's a new video tutorial that helps you add a contact page to your existing Shopify store. Please go through the video and add a contact form to your Shopify store. And then get back to this video to modify the form fields. In order to modify this form fields, we'll have to modify the code in the template that we are using. So let's go to Shopify admin, go to actions and click on edit code. This will take you to the Shopify code editor. And here you can search for the file that you want to modify. We'll search for page.contact.liquid. So this is the file that we'll modify to add fields to existing contact form. So this is the code for the contact form that we see here in the front end. So let's go through the code here. Everything that is in between this form tag here till this end form is a part of the contact form that we see here. Each field, name, email, phone number, and message is present in between the form start form tag and the end form tag here. This part is the name, this is the email, this is the phone number, message, and this is the submit button that we click when we submit the form. Here in this form, we'll add a new form field above the phone number. We'll try to add a dropdown, a text field, and two radio buttons. To add the fields to our contact form, we'll try to reuse the code available on the Shopify support forum. Let's go to the Shopify support forum. I'll post this link in the description box below. You can visit the link and find these fields on the Shopify support forum. Here we have the code for a text field, a radio button, drop-down menu, and a checkbox. We'll reuse the code for text field, radio button, and the drop-down menu that we are going to add to the contact form into our website. So we'll copy the code for text field, radio button, and drop-down one by one and paste it into our code here. This is the code for the text field. Next, we'll copy the code for the radio button. Next, we copy the code for the drop-down menu. It's here. Okay, we'll select everything and we'll properly indent it. As you can see, other fields align properly. Okay, let's save the changes and just check if these fields are available in the front end, and then we'll modify it according to our requirements. Okay, so we have these fields available here. We can change the labels and everything according to our requirements. We will modify this birthday field to a company field. So let's change the text. We'll replace birthday to company. I'll call this label as company name. Replace birthday to company. Okay, this name will appear here above the text field. This is the placeholder which corresponds to this. So let's save and check if the field is updated. Okay, so the company field is available here instead of the birthday field. Now let's modify this radio button fields into a gender field. We'll go to admin. We'll modify this. Do you prefer tea or coffee to gender? Next, we'll modify both the radio buttons at the same time to call them male and female. This is a type that specifies that this is the radio button, this is the ID of the radio button. So we'll call this male as the first option and ID of the second option as female. The name of the radio buttons should be same. So we'll call this as contact and in bracket we'll put gender. So this should be same for both the radio buttons. So we'll keep this same for both of them. We'll modify the values of them. These values will be sent to you as an email. So you can modify this as per your requirement. So let's call this male and call this female. And these are the labels of the radio button which appears here in the contact form. This tea and coffee, these are the labels that corresponds to this text. So let's call this male and this as the female. One more thing that you might have noticed is this choose a flavor is a part of this drop down. So in order to make this as a group, we'll have to enclose the entire radio button content into a different div. So let's do that. Let's create a div here and close it at the end of the radio button and reindent the content again. Save it and let's check the front end. Okay, so now here, choose the flavor is here and everything is properly aligned now. So now if you want to add a new radio button here as a rather not say, so let's, what we'll do is I will copy this existing radio button here and paste it. We'll modify this as none. We'll set this value as none, modify this as none again and save it. Let's refresh the page and we will have a new radio button below female. Yeah, we have it here. So that's how you modify the radio buttons. Let's move on to the drop down menu. We'll call this choose a flavor as country name and we'll add country names here in the drop down. Let's go to admin and modify this. The label will be called as country name. So we'll call this as country. The label should be called country name. And this should be country as well. This is the name of the label. You must make sure that these labels must be properly set, otherwise the form might not work properly. These are the options that you may provide in the drop down. So this country names may be USA, Canada, Russia, India, and you can add as many options as you want. Let's save this and check the front end. Okay, so we have the all new drop down here, country name. One thing that I missed telling you is the male and female appeared below each other and the name none part appeared besides female. This was because we missed a BR tag here besides the female. We'll copy this BR tag from male and keep it with female. Let's save it and check the front end. The none should appear below female now. Moreover, if you want all these three radio buttons to appear besides each other, just remove this tag BR from male and from female. The changes are saved and let's refresh the front end. Okay, so we have all of them besides each other. So that's how you can modify the contact form. Now let's fill up this contact form and check if we receive this on our email. Company name is Ishi Themes. Select the gender as male, country India, phone number, enter dummy phone number here. This is a sample contact form. If you have done everything right, modified the snippets correctly, we should get the content which is filled up by the customer when customer clicks on send. Okay, the form has been successfully submitted. Let's check the email if you have received this form. So we've received the data that was submitted by the customer on our contact form on the website. name, email, company, gender, country, phone number and message. These were the fields created by us in the contact form, and that these are the exact values that were submitted by us. So everything has worked right. So that's how you modify a contact form and you get all the data that you've modified in the contact form in your email. So that's it for the tutorial. If you have not yet subscribed the channel, please do it now to get quick updates of the new hack videos as soon as they're released.